Family homelessness is the largest growing segment of the homeless population.
Anybody can be homeless. It does not discriminate.
A lot of times they come into the shelter and they think that this is kind of the worst thing that has ever happened to them. They are at the bottom. They never imagined that this would be them. And shortly after, I hear client after client saying, this was the best thing that ever happened to me. This was time that I could stop and I could work on myself and I could get myself strong so I know who I am and I could learn to be a different kind of parent and a different kind of role model for my children. And I have hope now.
When we had first come here and walked in the doors, it was, you know, a relief because I seen that it was nice. And, you know, the staff that had welcomed us were very nice.
The Red Shield is pretty much known for being a very warm and nurturing shelter, and we tend to get a lot of the younger moms who will need a lot of support, as well as some folks with a history of mental health issues. These are young women who have about a fourth grade reading level. They have gone to school till about 11th grade. They have had no job experience whatsoever and are now parents themselves of often one or two little ones. So it's really changed the nature of our work, where we would have been a lot more recovery focused. We are really doing a lot more nurturing and development of these young folks that we're seeing here.
They come into a changed culture, a culture that doesn't tolerate any violence. It's a trauma-informed model that we use called Sanctuary. And we provide sort of holistic services for them. So although the end result is that they move into transitional housing, a lot of other healing has to happen for them to be successful once, you know, permanently once they move into their housing. So we're going to be working with them to understand how their trauma background is interfering with their ability to parent. And we're going to, in doing this and helping them heal from some of their trauma, we're going to help them learn to be more empathetic and sensitive to their child's cues and their child's needs.
We got introduced to the staff members and it really amazed me how well staff works with people, you know, with the people that live here, because they don't look down on you.
Learning about trust, learning that there is a person that really is there for them, that can care for them, that they can feel safe enough to feel their feelings that they've run from their whole lives is really important.
Residents who come into the Red Shield, they need to have a safe place.
Some of the folks that had just come into the shelter said, safe? Nothing's ever been safe. But you know, when they're here, a couple months down the line, and you see them making friends, you see them, you know, coming in and sharing with us their joys, sharing with us their pain, you begin to see, yeah, it begins to be the first safe place they've ever been in. There's a mural downstairs that we did as a whole house project. Each family got to do a piece of the puzzle. And one of the residents turned around and said, I never knew that I had a place where I belonged. I finally found the piece of the puzzle where I fit.
The one thing that hasn't changed over time is that the Red Shield has heart.
Just one big family. I mean, we had great love in that shelter.
And it's really kind of rebuilding these young spirits so that they can develop the confidence to be on their own and on the road to self-sufficiency.
The family there, the people there, the residents, they all became our family. I never experienced anything like that in my life, nowhere. But that was a life-changing experience for me. And now I have hope for mankind. The Salvation Army is truly some place that you can receive salvation.
I literally beg for people to just be a part of this so the doors can stay open, because there's so many more people out there that needs to come in.
It is so important for people to get involved and to give to the Red Shield. The city and federal governments are cutting funding. Private donations that are given and funding that are given through private donors help shelters and help different social service agencies to survive through the cuttings that are happening within the government. Also, giving also can come in terms of volunteering. In order to change the perception of homelessness and in order to educate the community about homelessness, people need to get involved.
I'm grateful, you know, to have a place where me and my daughter could have went when we didn't have no place. And a lot of days I thank my God for having places like this, because without these places, it'd be a whole lot of lost souls.